Hello all! Welcome back to season 3 of What's What, your very own show full of electricity, full of science, and today full of mystery. What mystery, you ask? Well, the mystery around one of the greatest and influential inventors in the history of electricity, one who, until today, was vastly unknown. But before we can examine this circuit of clues, don't forget to like and subscribe below. Let the investigation begin. So, everyone knows of the competition between Thomas Edison and Nikola Tesla. Of course, there is evidence of their incredible achievements, their patents. The numerous texts, films, and documentaries made in their honor. But how about we examine a third genius of electricity? A man unrecognized and underappreciated? A Frenchman named Gustave Trouvé. Did you know that this mystery scientist was the first to invent a number of things we use today, such as electric cars, sparking swords made for theater plays, 100 years before the making of Star Wars, the dentist drill, the endoscope, and the headlamp powered by pocket batteries that became quickly very popular, but was finally marketed by Georges Leclanché. Then there was the oxanoscope, ancestor of the retroprojector. Without Trouvé, no keynotes, no PowerPoint will exist. With such achievements under his belt, why has this daring inventor been left out of the history books, out of the Hall of Fame of science? Is it because of controversy, theft? Behind his inventions, are there a list of crimes? Gustave had no children, no heir to carry on his legacy. He came from a modest life in a small French village, single and lonely, far from the pomp of the Parisian salon. But no, he was no criminal. He was a true and honest scientist, focused only on study and invention. That's right, people, hard work and dedication. But unlike his two more famous counterparts, you could say he lacked a business side. Many of his patents were stolen or ripped off, others remained stagnant after creations. Maybe good old Gustave didn't know how to sell. And that may explain why he's not as widely known as Edison or Tesla. He was so passionate about inventing that he even forgot about his legacy. To this day, there is only one street in the whole world which celebrates Gustave Trouvé. It hosts 4 houses on 50 meters of drive in the village where our lonely genius was born, Descartes. But like many unknown achievers, it was only a matter of time before the true greatness of Gustave was discovered by the masses. Thanks to the rigorous research of many great historians, such as Kevin Desmond, the work of Gustave is finally being recognized, and rightfully so. Digging through rare archives, Desmond was able to unearth, highlight, and attribute various inventions to Gustave Trouvé. And there were many, many inventions, even more than we ever imagined. Electromobile jewelry, a mechanical bell, portable military telegraph, bullet extractor, oxygen suites for aerial travel, the marine outboard motor, the electric tricycle, underwater lightning, even a luminous electric jump rope. And to think, all these great products, military equipment, travel vehicles, safety gadgets, medical tools, toys, were once an idea inside Gustave Trouvé's mind.
Ah, what the imagination can do.
And so, with Desmond's work, a new piece of scientific history was found. Funny enough, the name Trouvé actually translates into found or discovered in English. In fact, this found emblem was Trouvé's trademark, and Trouvé's newfound recognition is well earned. He may not have been the best businessman, but he sure came a long way. Trouvé was from a small village. His father was a cattle farmer. He left home in hope of opportunity, but unfortunately had to battle health issues for most of his university study. But that didn't stop Trouvé from pushing forward. He kept working and early in his career contributed as a writer for various science magazines before getting recognized for his specialties in miniaturization. He also worked as a locksmith where he learned and grew fascinated with working with his hands. Miniaturization is the development or invention of items
on the smaller scale.
This was what really kicked off Gustave's career. He invented tools that were portable, less bulky. These items could be carried and used somewhere other than the science lab, like say the field, the office, the playground, or your home. And living in today's age where compact is key, where the lightweight and portable is desired. It's no secret to say that Gustave's little inventions had a big impact. How? What's left to be found? I guess we can't all be Trouvé. Now, how about a quick summary? Although not as renowned as others of his time, Gustave Trouvé was an influential inventor and scientist. He specialized in miniaturization and across the span of 4 decades had over 75 inventions. Not bad for a French guy from the village, right? So, to all of you scientists out there, remember, stay focused on your work, keep creating, keep brainstorming, keep innovating, and keep inspiring. And don't give up, for one day your efforts will be Trouvé. That's it for our first episode of season 3, but there is much more to come. Thanks for tuning in, like and subscribe below. And as far as scientific inventions go, never stop searching for the new big or little thing.